Hey, this is Peter from Programming with Peter, and today we are going to continue with development of our posts from admin side. Let's get started. Hey there, I'm Peter, and today we are going to, like I said on our intro, we are going to change and put some tabs to our posts from admin side. But if you are new to this channel, please subscribe and you will get notified whenever I upload something new, and that is 1 to 3 times videos a week. So it's pretty cool, let's get started. First, we need to go to bootstrap.com. Let's search for Bootstrap. And search for the documentation and search for tabs. And we need to get the ones that are working with JS. So these ones. Let's copy that example. And we should go to our posts form.blade.php, because let's run our server php artisan serve. I'm going to localhost 8000 home. If you don't have your session already, it will ask you to log in. So admin/posts. Let's try to add new, and here we need to put two tabs, one for posts, normal fields, and one for CEO, which is keywords and description. So let's do that. We forgot here to put a select for tags, but yeah, we should do that too, but not today. So let's do that. Let's hide this terminal and paste whatever we copied from Bootstrap. Okay. We need only two, so we should remove the last li and the last tab pane. Let's put some, let's check this out, let's put here post details and SEO on the second one. And as for the content, let's remove these dots that they have. And we need to, like I said, we need to get the description and the keywords and put it in the content tab for SEO, so the second one. And all of that except the button, so all the fields, remaining fields actually, put it in the first tab. Let's refresh, and it is post details in SEO. Good. Now, as I said, since we have our, let's change these defaults that Bootstrap gave us. Home, it's not a good name. So it is post details and SEO. The tab pane need to have the same ID. So post details, and the second one should have SEO instead of profile, of course. Let's check if it is still working. It is. Tab content, let's put some margin to it. So margin top, so it is MI1, actually 2 or 3. Let's put it with 3. Good. A little bit more, yeah. Now we have our tabs, but what happens if we actually, let's save this right now and check if it is still working. Create. Okay, it is created. And on edit page, we have, because we put this in form.blade.php from posts folder, it is the same form used, so we have on both admin and create and edit view pages. Pretty good. Yep, I like it. Now that let's check the edit one update, actually test update, to see if it is working. Good. We need to transform this category ID. Actually, let's remove that label because it is just category. Even though it is a category ID field, label should be category because yeah, user don't need to know what kind of relation we have between them. He just wants a select to select a category. That's all. So going to before it is an input because we put it as an integer, which is right, but we don't need an input, we need a select. So let's go to Bootstrap. Getbootstrap.com, sorry. We had it here actually. And search for select. Dropdowns, maybe. I forgot. This doesn't have any fields. Actually, select is hard to style, so we don't have any. But let's do it like that. Text area, input. Let's put it, let's copy the category actually. Let's go to category post controller, sorry. And on our create, we need to get the categories. So categories equal category all. So importing the model on our top of the file. /category/. So this will give us all of the categories that we have on our DB. And to have access on it on our view, create view, we need to put a width, and which takes an array of key values. So the key should be the name that we have on our view, and the value should be the value from this function or this controller. So categories, going to the post create blade, if we did this die and dump, we have no categories here. And go back to add new, and it is an empty collection because we don't have any categories. But if we go to categories and add a new category, so category test create. Now going to the post add new, we have one category. Cool. So doing that, we need to go to the posts form, and instead of an input, so instead of a category, we should have, let's check this out, we should have a select with a name category ID, because that's what we will send. What happened there? I don't know. Let me disable this. Okay, category ID. ID could be category ID with no problem. And let's do a for each. On blade, for each, it is just like in PHP, just with I'm not sure how to spell it in English. So we have categories because we send it on our create, but it will get an error on edit because we didn't put it there either. Actually, we didn't put it there. We will do it in a moment. So for each categories in as, sorry, key, which is, we don't need the key, we just need the category. Let's name it category. Let's put an option tag with the value of category ID, sorry, and the name category name. So now we have a category select. Of course it is ugly, so we need to add classes. Class form control is the class for Bootstrap to give us a pretty. Yeah. So let's create another category before doing that. hit enter, going to post, add new. Now we have two categories here. Create. Column keywords cannot be null, insert into post, title. Okay. So we need to validate our field. But before doing that, let's actually test our category 2 and put something here, dummy. Okay, good. Now we have our post. Pretty cool. And let's display the category here. So, going to our posts. Let's actually go to posts index. And display after the slug, let's display the category. And we can do it like that. So for example, let's create, put a TD, because that is a table, so TD it means a column of item, category, name. Item here, it is being a post, it is iterating with a for each from post, so it is post. But we don't have the relation, I think. Yeah, let's see, check this out, post.php. Actually, it has a category, but not all of them have a category. So basically, it means that we need to check if we have a category. So if not, empty of item category, category name, else nothing. So only the last one has a category name. But what is this doing is that it will make a lot of queries to our MySQL. So solving this, because for each iteration it will go to DB and search for the category that each field has. So if you have two rows with the same category, it will query two times. But if we do what we will do right now, it will query only once for each category, so which is a lot better. Posts controller on our index, we should put for both of them with means with relation. So basically with category. Same goes for this one too. We don't see any much because yeah, we have only one category, one post with a category. So yeah, the performance is too low, but when you load like 100 or 200, it will be a lot more faster. Good. Okay. We did that too. Let's show the category here too on our show page. We can do it like that, going to show. It has a tier, I think we have to do. I'm not sure. So tier, th, td. No td, th. Ntd. Okay. Where the generator. So the category should be post category name. We don't have to do the same with category because yeah, we have only one post here, so it don't do anything. Undefined variable categories, if we go to edit, which I said it will happen, so we need to go to posts controller and do the same with categories all to the edit view, and instead of compact, it means take this variable which I have on this function with this name as a string and put it with the same name on our view. So for example, post, it takes the post from find or fail and put it as post on view. What we need is the same width, categories. Pretty good. So having here category 2, we change it to category 2. Let's add one, update, category test. Let's update it again to test it. Pretty cool, right? Doing good. We show the category. Edit it is working. Back. Let's delete this too. Just to test our functionality. And it is working pretty good. Let's stop. Yeah. It's okay. Let's commit these changes. And put. And put it like that. Let me see. Add tabs for admin, post, SEO, and post details. Add select for post categories on post creation. Let's commit it. Today, we stopped a little early, just because we have to validate our fields and it will take us a lot of time. But on the next episode, we should do that. Thank you for watching and please subscribe if you enjoy my videos. See you on next one.